Dear students, good morning. Now we will enter into inorganic chemistry. So in that we will discuss S block elements. So here non-numerical part completely theory. So inorganic chemistry we have to follow only NCERT and our notes. Okay, after completion of class you should write notes properly so that you will have full clarity about this chapter and this inorganic chemistry. Not only this chapter, entire inorganic chemistry is theory, is completely based on textbook. So if you know one by one every point about all these chapters, and in every chapter each concept is very important. Which concept is important, like that we cannot say. So one advantage is that in NEET question or JEE whatever, inorganic question came means we can answer directly. But only thing is we have to remember many topics in this inorganic chemistry. So for this inorganic chemistry to understand, you must know full clarity about yes, periodic classification mainly and chemical bonding. These two chapters are very very important for you. Okay, so after class also if you will have assignment, no? So from periodic table and chemical bonding also you will have few questions in our assignment daily. Okay, because to understand inorganic chemistry those are also very important. Okay, let's start. This S block elements. So first we will discuss about 1A group elements. You know everyone periodic table. So we have four blocks: S block, P block, in middle D block, and bottom you have F block. So S block elements we will discuss now. S block elements means what exactly? S block elements means both 1A and 2A group elements. So 1A group elements are called what? You know already we call them as alkali metals. What these are? Alkali metals. Alkali metals. Alkali metals means basic in nature. Alkaline means what is the meaning? Basic metals. Basic nature they have. What are the bases? Bases means we have equilibrium chapter. According to Lewis, who donate electrons, they are called bases. We discussed or not? So bases, because these have a tendency to donate electrons. Not only that, with water or with the hydrogen or they are sorry with water mainly or dilution, they form hydroxides, NaOH like that. Okay, so metals forms hydroxides, and metal with hydrogen hydrides, they are basic in nature. So that's why we have to call these as alkali metals. Okay, alkali means what? Basic in nature, so which has a tendency to donate electrons. So actually 1A group elements means we have hydrogen. So about hydrogen we have a chapter. Actually hydrogen won't come as alkali metal. Okay, so S block elements means hydrogen, helium also will come along with remaining elements. Hydrogen, helium, and 1A group elements means you have lithium, that sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, all comes under 1A group element. So hydrogen is the first element we place in a periodic table, but hydrogen is not a metal. Hydrogen we won't consider as alkali metal. Hydrogen configuration is a similar, that's it, 1s1, sorry. So that's why hydrogen we called we include with 1A group elements in S block. Okay, along with alkali metals hydrogen placed, but hydrogen is not alkali metal. Remember this one. Hydrogen has configuration 1s1, which is similar configuration, which is the general electronic configuration of alkali metals. So these alkali metals has a general electronic configuration which we call NS1. Okay, so hydrogen has a configuration 1s1, so hydrogen is not alkali metal. Then what we have, sir? Hydrogen is not alkali metal, you say. About hydrogen we have chapter, we will discuss that later. Okay, next, what are the elements which comes under this alkali metals, means 1A group element? Lithium and sodium and potassium and rubidium and cesium and francium. Today is completely introduction. Okay, so lithium atomic number is 3. So you know period elements. Period. So what the period number? It's a second period and third period, fourth period, fifth period, sixth period, and seventh period. So these elements are belong to which period? I written now. So period number. I written here. Now here this is atomic number. I am writing here. Okay. In second period, how many elements will be there? 8 elements are there. And in third period, also 8. And in fourth, 18. Fifth, 18. Sixth, it's 32. In sixth, 32 elements will be present or not? And in seventh, there are 32 elements. Right? So, atomic number, I told you. If you want sodium atomic number, add above elements I said in periodic table. You remember or not? Okay. But if you want atomic number of P block elements, same period elements you have to add to get atomic number of a particular. I want atomic number of sodium. So sodium atomic number I don't know. So for this I will add above period elements. Means above for sodium who is above period? Second period. In second period total elements how many? 8. 8 plus 3 so 11. Similar way. I want for potassium. So above period means third. In third how many elements are there? 8. 8 plus 11? 19. Okay. So this one. 19 plus 18. So how much you will get, sir, here? Here 37 you will get. Atomic number. Because 19 plus 18. Correct? 37. Okay. So here what you will get? 57 plus 32. So here what you will get? 27. See, sorry, not this. This you have to add, no? Sorry. 8 plus 7 again. Okay? 5. So, 55. Here, 55 plus 32. Then you will get this one. 55 plus 32. Above period element, no? For francium. Above period elements means 6th period. Total number of elements are 32. 32 plus 55. So, it's 2 plus 5, 7. 87. So, these are the atomic numbers of these particular group elements. So hydrogen also you have here, as I mentioned here, hydrogen atomic number is 1 and 1s1 comes under the same group, but hydrogen is a gas, it's a diatomic gas, hydrogen, everybody knows. That's why I am not writing hydrogen here. Okay, hope you understood. So next is the most important atomic numbers, how we got. So 3 plus 8, 11 plus 8, 19 plus 18, 37 plus 18, 55 plus 32, then you will get this one. Above period elements, you have to, above period consists how many elements? Here 6th period is the above period for francium. So 32 elements are present in above period. 32 plus 55, so you will get 87. These are the atomic numbers. And one more important thing is, these all if you see, lithium is just after helium. Helium and lithium, and this is sodium. So sodium is the next element to neon. So for sodium, the before element is what? Neon. Like that. See, potassium, here argon. Okay. And rubidium, here helium, neon, argon, krypton here. And here like that, cesium. And here xenon, like this. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon are noble gases or not, tell me. So these are highly stable as we know, which has octet configuration. Of course, helium has a duplet configuration. So, this lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, this all comes under, this comes after noble gases actually. So, helium after lithium actually comes under next. So, helium here actually, so here comes lithium, next period. Helium comes under first period, but lithium comes under second period, like that. Understanding? Neon comes under second, sodium comes under third period, sodium comes under third period like that. What I am saying, understanding? So like this actually. So if you see, these are the noble gases. So noble gases, actually first period and second period, third period, fourth period, fifth period, sixth period, seventh period. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon here and octium here you have. You know this already. So here what you have? So helium after. Helium will finish in first period. But neon. Okay, so neon after, sorry, neon, not helium after. So lithium will start here in second period. Okay, so neon ends in second period, sodium starts in third period, like that. Argon ends in third period, next here potassium starts in fourth period. So these are next elements to noble gases or not? Here I previously written like that, just for understanding. Why I arrive that, you may think helium and lithium belongs to same period. No. So lithium before element will become helium, that helium is belongs to first period. Like that sodium before element is neon, that is that belongs to second period. Like that. So potassium before element is argon, or argon is the next element to, potassium is the next element to argon, but argon is third, but potassium is fourth, like that. So here, same, krypton is the fourth, but rubidium starts after krypton, like this. Same, xenon after cesium, like this. So that's why I written, so lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium I written. So xenon ends in fifth period, but cesium starts in sixth period. These are very, very important. Why I am telling all these things? Because helium next element lithium means helium configuration is 1s2. So lithium configuration is 1s2 2s1. So it has one extra electron. So these all elements will have one extra electron than their corresponding noble gases. So for lithium, who is the corresponding noble gas? Means not neon. Corresponding means nearest one, helium. For sodium, who is the nearest one? Means neon. For potassium, who is the nearest? Means argon. For rubidium, who is the nearest? Means krypton, like that. So these all have one extra electron than their corresponding noble gases. So this is very, very important thing. So if you see hydrogen, 1s1. So before hydrogen, who is there? Nobody. Hydrogen is the starting element of entire elements what we have. Entire periodic table, starting element is hydrogen in an entire periodic table. Got it? So now comes to this electronic configuration. As I said, this is the general electronic configuration. General or electronic configuration of Mr. alkali metals. What is the alkali metals? 1A group elements, atomic number, its periodic number actually. So lithium is the next element to Mr. helium. So generally if you write it's 1s2 2s1, that's it. Or else you can write it's just you can write like this. It's the next element to Mr. helium, no? So helium configuration is 1s2. 1s2 is nothing but helium configuration. So helium 2s1, that's it. So here you can write sodium means 1s2, 2s2 and 2b6 and 3s1. Total atomic number is 11, 2 plus 2 plus 6, 10, 10 plus 1, 11. Or else sodium is the next element to neon. So you can write Mr. Neon 3s1. And potassium you can write like this. 1s2, 2s2 and 2b6, 3s2 and 3b6 and you can write 4s1. See? You know that already. Belongs to what period? Fourth period. So this is the period number, which we call valence shell. Correct? Valence shell means highest N value. You know that. So 4 is the highest here. So this is the valence shell. In valence shell, this is called principal quantum number. This principal quantum number value is the period number. Okay? So you know, period number is equals to principal quantum number of valence shell. Principal quantum number is 4. Yeah. That's why I told you, even for these electronic configurations, atomic structure also very important, electronic configurations. Okay, so that you can write this, see, 1s2, 2s2, 2b6, 2 plus 2 plus 6, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 6, 18. So it's, we can call it as simply argon 4s1. Like that you can write now. So helium 2s1, neon 3s1, and this one is argon 4s1. So rubidium, still you can write like that, but waste of time. Argon, so it's a So why I written that understood? So for rubidium, the previous element is a krypton, like this. Argon next is potassium. Krypton next is rubidium. So rubidium means krypton. It's a 4s1. So here 5s1. 36. It's 37. And here next xenon next element is cesium. Xenon and 6s1. And francium. It's you can say xenon after radon. Okay, so 7s1 like this. So if you see this valence shell here, 2s, 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s and 7s. So from all these things you can say general electronic configuration of 1a group elements is ns1, that's it. So these are about electronic configurations and their atomic numbers, and these are the what a relation you have with the noble gas hydrogen for these alkali metals, how we can relate with the noble gases hydrogen there. So here I written alkali metals, alkali metals relation with this noble gases, their atomic numbers and their period number actually. So even you don't know their period number, you can understand like this from a valence shell. Okay, what will be the valence shell for rubidium? If you know the period, you can say valence shell is 5, because rubidium is belongs to 5th period, like this. Got it, sir, everyone? So this is about electronic configuration. Have a screenshot. So what we discussed means many things, like why these are called alkali metals. Okay, so what is the electronic configuration, what are their atomic numbers, what is their period numbers, and what is the general electronic configuration, what are the previous noble gas element for these alkali metals. Okay, so like that we discussed. Okay, so where these present, so these, what is the availability of alkali metals? So mostly alkali metals won't available in free state. Why alkali metals, sir, we have to extract actually. Alkali metals cannot exist in free state. They exist in combined state. How? As chlorides. Everybody knows sodium main source is what? Common salt, NaCl. What is NaCl? It's a common salt. Everybody knows sodium chloride. Like that sodium carbonate, washing soda, okay, so sodium bicarbonate, this all availability or source of this particular alkali metals. Lithium available as LaCl. So mainly how these available alkali metals available in their particular salt forms only. Salt forms like MCl, M2SO4, M2CO3, MHCO3. What is M here? M is lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, like that. Okay, so actually francium compounds won't exist because francium is a radioactive element. Okay, so everybody knows periodic properties. Okay, atomic radius, what happened, and all those, you know. So if you see lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium, if you see hydrogen, I'm not writing. So as going down, what happens? Atomic radius increases, ionization potential decreases, correct? Electronegativity decreases, electropositivity increases. Positive means losing tendency, electronegative means attracting tendency. Electropositive nature increases, that means electronegative tendency decreases, electropositive nature increases as going down. So like this, as going down metallic nature increases. So metallic nature is going down. What happened? Increases. Okay. So it's all are very very important. Okay. And one more important thing is reactivity. Who is, what is the order of reactivity? If you see, means who is most reactive. So if you see order of reactivity, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Okay, francium we cannot consider. It's a radioactive element. Its lifetime is very very less. Okay, so this is the order. Why I am not writing francium? You don't know. Don't think like that. Its lifetime is very less. Half time we call. Okay, so that is very less. It is a highly reactive. Radioactive means what is the meaning? It absorbs radiation and it emits radiation continuously. So that's why it is unstable. No compounds exist for this transition. So this is order of reactivity. So highest reactive metal is what means cesium. Okay, you can check by simple reaction actually. Lithium, if we pour in water, small sound will come. Sodium, somewhat explosive. Potassium, more explosive. Rubidium, too much explosive. Cesium, if you pour, big blow will come. Understanding? So that much high reactivity you can see. Getting what I'm saying? That's why this all extraction, how happens I'll tell you. But this all we will store in some unreactive solvents. Okay? Chemically inert solvents like kerosene. Okay, and these are very soft, soft metals. We can cut with knife also. These are some general properties. Okay, you have to write. Reactivity is like that. These are very soft. This means what? 1A group elements are, 1A group metals are very soft, soft metals. We can cut with knife also. These stored in kerosene because of their high reactivity. Why they are high reactivity, I told you already. Because they have one extra electron. So they readily lose electron. So that they will get noble gas configuration or not. Because sodium is the next element to neon. So what is the difference between neon and sodium? Only one difference. What is that difference? Neon has a configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. And sodium has a configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. What is the difference you have here? This electron is the difference. So sodium can readily lose this 3s electron. Correct. So that can easily convert into octet configuration like the sodium can easily turns more stable like neon. So sodium can easily get octet configuration by losing this 3s electron. Clear? So in this way you can understand what these alkali metals are highly reactive. Why? They have one extra electron than their respective or corresponding noble gas. What is the corresponding noble gas to Mr. Neon? Sorry. Corresponding noble gas to Mr. Sodium is a neon. Okay. So like that. So if it lose one electron, it can get noble gas configuration. So we can write like this. Sodium is a gas and it turns to Na plus plus one electron. What is the difference between Na and Na plus? Not only Na, all alkali metals can lose one electron, as I mentioned in previous. What is the difference? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. So here you have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 2 plus 6, 8, which is called octet configuration. So this we call as octet configuration or not? So yeah, after losing, this will be octet configuration or not. So it can easily lose one electron. So sodium can readily converts to Na plus. Okay. So this is about some general information about alkali metals. They won't exist in a free state. They exist in combined state. We can extract them as metals. but it is a difficult process. By electrolysis of a fused salts of these alkali metals, we can get these free state alkali metals. I'll tell you those, okay? But before that, you should have all information, everybody. So these have oxidation state. One more thing, oxidation state always plus one. I told you. So these the valency. What is the valency of 1A group elements? Always one only. Valency we won't use plus and minus, correct? Oxidation state always plus one, correct? Okay, these are basic. Okay, these can combine with hydrogen and form hydrides, and these form hydrides with like this NaH like this. These forms oxides like this Na2. These forms hydroxides with NaOH. I return with sodium. You can apply same with lithium. For lithium you can apply same. For potassium you can apply same. Got it? So like this, the most important thing. Okay. So these all compounds also basic. Hydrides are basic. These are basic oxides. And this is a base atom. Sodium hydroxide is base, everybody knows. Okay, so not only metals, their compounds also basic in nature. Please note it down, everyone. Okay, so this is the most important introduction about alkali metals. Okay, it's useful for you. As I said, hydrides, I told you, when they combine with hydrogen, they form hydrides. So about hydrides we will discuss later. So how hydrides will form? See, M means what? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, like this. With H2 you will get MH. I told you these have oxidation state plus one, valency one, so they will combine like that, everybody. It's very simple. MH I said, no, so LiH, so NaH, and Mr. KH, RbH, and CsH. As going away from lithium to cesium, this basic nature increases. Because as going down, metallic nature increases or not? So reactivity increases or not? So basic nature is more. Okay? So which has more lattice energy, if they ask? I'll tell you about all these later. Lattice energy. You have to think one thing. Lattice energy that depends on size. Cesium Cs plus is very big actually. H minus actually here. It is small. That's why this has less interactions actually. But here lithium Li plus is small because as going down size increases. No, I said in previous. Atomic radius increases, same time ionic radius also as going down increases. So H minus, this size also small. So both are small, more interactions. So this has more lattice energy. More lattice energy like this. So very very important, please remember all this. So lattice energy, if you see LiH is greater than, NaH is greater than, KH is greater than, RbH is greater than, CsH actually. Basic nature increases. Why hydrogen has minus charge understood? Sir, hydrogen is positive, no sir. With in water or in HCl, H plus here, Cl minus. Because halogens are more, non-metals are more electronegative. I told you clearly in previous. With non-metals, hydrogen has positive oxidation state. With metals, hydrogen has a negative oxidation state, I said. So about hydrides, about oxides and their extraction of alkali metals, everything we will discuss in our next class. Thank you. And as I said, you have to just revise periodic table and chemical bonding also. Thank you.